Well, hello, folks. My name is JC. Hola, amigos. Soy JC, and I'm your Spanish instructor. Y soy vuestro profesor de español. All right. So, in this video, we are going to talk about common errors. All right. We're going to talk about common errors. En este video vamos a hablar de errores comunes. It's a video for level B2 in Spanish. Es un nivel B2 en español. And they are very easy to make. These errors are very easy to make, especially when we translate literally from English into Spanish or vice versa. Especialmente cuando traducimos del español al inglés o viceversa, son errores muy típicos de cometer. Alright, so I've selected only 6 for this video. He seleccionado solo 6 para este video, but there are more. In fact, there are many more. Pero hay más, de hecho hay muchos más. Alright, but let's go over these 6 to see how it goes, okay? Vamos a repasar estos 6 a ver qué tal, ¿vale? So, number 1. To realize, realize. In English you say realize, and in Spanish we don't say realizarse. En español no decimos realizarse. We rather say darse cuenta, darse cuenta. For instance, I didn't realize. In Spanish you don't say no me realicé. So we say no me di cuenta. So I didn't realize, no me di cuenta. Okay? Number 2, ask. The verb ask means preguntar, doesn't mean pedir, which is the next one. So, preguntar, no pedir. We don't say pedir, we say preguntar. For example, I asked where she lived. I asked where she lived. We don't say in Spanish, en español no decimos, le pedí donde vivía. We say, le pregunté donde vivía, because the translation is preguntar, not ask, not pedir. Okay? Now, and this one is different, alright? Ask for. Número 3 es distinto. Ask for significa pedir, no preguntar. All right? So, for instance, I ask him for a cigarette. I ask him for a cigarette. We don't say in Spanish, en español no decimos, le pregunté un cigarrillo. So, we say, decimos, le pedí un cigarrillo. Because, again, ask for es pedir, no es preguntar. All right? So, that's as far as the first 3 is concerned. Eso en cuanto a los 3 primeros se refiere. But let's concentrate on numbers 4, 5, and 6. Vamos a concentrarnos en el 4, 5 y 6, ¿ok? Now, move, move, could be moverse. For example, move from one seat or one chair to another one. Okay, it could be moverse. But in this context, it means mudarse. Move puede ser moverse, dependiendo del contexto. Estás en una silla y te mueves a otra. O estás en una parte del sofá y te mueves a otra parte del sofá. Okay? But in this context, en este contexto, significa, o lo traducimos por mudarse. For instance, listen to the question, or to the sentence. I'm going to move to another house. I'm going to move to another house. So we use the word mudarse. Utilizamos la palabra mudarse. And the sentence is not me voy a mover a otra casa. We don't say that. So we say me voy a mudar a otra casa. Okay? Because in this context we use mudarse and not moverse. In this context. Okay? Now number 5. Number 5. In the morning. A very common error. In the morning. Many people tend to say en la mañana. So they translate in for en, but it is incorrect. Right? So in Spanish we say por la mañana. Está mal decir en la mañana. Te entenderían, people would understand, but it's not grammatically correct. So we say por la mañana, ¿vale? For example, I get up early in the morning. And that one is true, by the way. I get up early in the morning. So we don't say me levanto temprano en la mañana. Again, people would understand you 100%, but it's not right. So we tend to say me levanto temprano por la mañana. Okay, so we don't say in, we say por. All right, and the last one. Support. Now, support no es soportar. That would be put up with, all right? Or stand. Put up with or stand. So, support, we use the word apoyar in Spanish. We use the word apoyar. For instance, I support everything you do. We don't say soporto todo lo que haces because that would mean I put up with everything you do, all right? So, it's totally different. The meaning is totally different. So, we don't say that and we say apoyo todo lo que haces, ok? I support everything you do, we say apoyo todo lo que haces. Alright, so I hope you have learned a few things with this video, alright? Again, this is level B2 in Spanish. Espero que hayas aprendido algunas cositas con este video, el nivel B2 en español. And if you're going to learn more, si quieres aprender más, subscribe to our channel. Suscríbete a nuestro canal si quieres aprender más. Lingua Hispana, ok? Where you can find lots of videos, different levels, not only about this, but about different areas of the language. De todos los niveles, no solo sobre esto, sino de diferentes aspectos del idioma español. Alright, so again, subscribe. And one more thing, if you like this video, please click on like. Si te gustó este video, por favor, haz click en like. Alright, so that's all for today, folks. I'll see you in another video. Okay, gracias por todo, gracias por vernos. Thank you for watching. Eso es todo por hoy. Goodbye. Adiós.